वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल. टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द फार्माकोग्नोसी ऑफ लिकोरिस एंड डायस्कोरिया. दीज आर द ग्लाइकोसाइड कंटेनिंग ड्रग्स. सो फर्स्ट ड्रग इज द लिकोरिस, विच इज कॉमनली नोन एज द मुलेठी स्वीट लिकोरिस, और वी कैन से रेडिक्स ग्लिसराइजी. And if you see the biological source of this drug, the useful part of this drug is the stolons, roots, stems, and botanical name is Glycyrrhiza glabra, and it's belong to family Leguminaceae. So as a biological source, we can say that licorice consists of subterranean peeled and unpeeled stolons, roots, and subterranean stems of Glycyrrhiza glabra and other species of Glycyrrhiza which are belong to family Leguminaceae. And geographically these are mainly cultivated in China, Europe, India, Iraq, Japan, Kurdistan, Spain, Turkey and other United States. So it is all about the biological source and about the geographical source. So in biological source you have to remember always, you have to write about the useful parts, its botanical name and its family. And if we see about the cultivation and collections of the drug, so it require the moist sandy soil for the cultivation. So we can say that the plant require a deep, well cultivated, fertile, moisture retentive sandy soil for the good production. So we can say that soil required much more moisture there should be in the soil, and the type of soil should be sandy, and it should also be alkaline in nature if we want to produce a good quality of the plant. So the quality of soil should consist some alkalinity, and it can be propagated by using the seeds and root. And if we want to cultivate with the help of the seeds, so we have to pre-soak the seeds for 24 hours in warm water, then sown in the month of springs or autumn in a greenhouse, and then seedlings are individually potted when they are large enough to handle, and grown them for their first winter in a greenhouse. Then they can be transplanted in a late spring or early summer when it activate growth. Plants are rather slow to grow from the seed. So we can say when we are growing plants from the seeds, so the plants obtaining from the seeds, there will be growth slow in compared to the root. If we are doing cultivation with the help of the root, there will be the faster growth of the plant, whereas in case of seeds, the growth of the plants will be little bit slow. And harvesting generally occurs in the autumn of the fourth year. So we can say that when the plant reach the age of 3 to 4 years, after that harvesting can be carried out, and normally it is carried out in the season of autumn. So it is all about the cultivations and collections of licorice. And if we talk about the morphological characters of the drug, so internally it is yellowish in color, whereas externally it is dark brown in color. And odor is faint and characteristic. Taste is sweet. Size, length 20 to 50 centimeter, whereas it is 2 centimeter in diameter, and it is cylindrical in shape. And if you see the fracture, so fracture is fibrous types. And if we compare the peeled and unpeeled piece of the drug, so we can observe that in case of unpeeled pieces, there will be presence of small buds encircling the scaly and longitudinals, and the longitudinal is the drug is wrinkled. So you can see here some wrinkles are there, and they are present as a longitudinally, they wrinkles are present, whereas peeled surface is fibrous and there will be no wrinkles in the peeled surface. So it is the difference between the unpeeled and peeled surface. And if we see the microscopic characters of the drug, so you can see that outermost layer is the cork regions, which consists the tubular cells which are arranged radially. So this outer region is the cork regions, and few 10-12 layers of the cork cells may be there, and they are radially arranged. After the cork region, there is the phalloderms, which is composed of either parenchymatous cells, or sometimes it may also composed of the collenchymatous cells. So this region is the phalloderms, and this region also consists of some starch granules, and calcium oxalate crystals are also present in the phalloderms. After that, we can see that so pericyclic fibers are found in a group. So many pericyclic fibers are present in the drugs which are available in the group. So surrounding the phloems, you can see that these are also pericyclic fibers which are present. And phloem consists the sieve tissues alternating with the thick wall lignified fibers surrounded by a sheath of parenchymatous cells containing prism of calcium oxalate. So these phloems is there, and they are surrounded by the fibers, lignified fibers. So we can say that with the fluoroglucinol and hydrochloric acid, these lignified fibers will give the pink color. To identify, we can use reagent fluoroglucinol and HCl in the ratio of 1:1, and these lignified tissues or cells may be identified. And these phloem fibers are surrounded by the parenchymatous cells, and these parenchyma consist the some calcium oxalate crystals which are prism type. We can say that prism type of calcium oxalate crystals are normally present, and xylem vessels and xylem parenchyma also present. So you can see here the xylem vessels, xylem fibers are there, then xylem parenchymatous, xylem parenchyma, which are surrounding the vessels. And in this region you can see also the medullary rays. These medullary rays are present, which are radially elongated. And here is the presence of pith. But one important thing about the pith is that the pith is present in case of rhizomes, whereas it is absent in the root. So this diagram is the TS of rhizomes of the licorice, because pith is present in the rhizomes, whereas it is absent in the root. So these it is all about the microscopy of licorice. And if you see the chemical constituent of the drug, so major active constituent of the drug is the glycyrrhizin, which is present approximately 6 to 8%, and it is more sweeter than the sucrose, and we can say that 50 times more sweeter than sucrose. And it is a white crystalline powder which consists calcium and potassium salt of glycyrrhizic acid. And this glycyrrhizic acid on hydrolysis yield the glycyrrhitic or glycyrrhitinic acid. Okay, on hydrolysis, this glycyrrhizic acid will give two product. First one is the glycyrrhitic acid, and second one is the glycyrrhitinic acid. So you can see the structures of glycyrrhitic acids and glycyrrhitinic acids. And other than this glycyrrhizin, the drug also contain the sugar starch, which may be approximately 29%, gums protein fat 0.8%, fat may be 0.8%, resins, and asparagine is 2 to 4%. So it is all about the chemical constituents of the drug. And if you see the identifications of tests, so we have to take 80% of sulfuric acid, which we will add to the drug sample. So orange yellow color will produce because of the transformations of the flavone glycoside leucuritine to calcone glycoside isoleucuritine. Okay, that this is the flavone glycoside leucuritine. It will convert into the calcone glycoside, that is isoleucuritine. So due to which it will give the orange yellow color on treatment with the sulfuric acid. And it is commonly used as an expectorant, demulcent, as a flavoring agent in the many various formulations, in the treatment of peptic ulcer to form the deglycerized licorice, short form of this is DGL. एंड इट्स आल्सो यूज्ड एज ए एंटी स्पाजमोटिक बिकॉज ऑफ द आइसोल्यूकेरिटिन विच इज अ फ्लेवोनॉइड ग्लाइकोसाइड्स, जो जो हमने कहा था आपको कि दैट इज आइडेंटिफिकेशन टेस्ट में येलो कलर इज प्रोड्यूसिंग बिकॉज ऑफ द आइसोल्यूकेरिटिन, एंड दिस बिकॉज ऑफ दिस आइसोल्यूकेरिटिन इट इज आल्सो यूजफुल इन एज ए एंटी स्पाजमोटिक. So now next drug is the Dioscorea, which is commonly known as the yam, or we can say rheumatism root, and it is obtained from the rhizomes of various species of the Dioscorea like Dioscorea villosa, Dioscorea prageri, Dioscorea composite, Dioscorea spiculiflora, Dioscorea deltoidea, Dioscorea floribunda. And these all species are belonging to family Dioscoreaceae. And if we talk about the geographical source in context of India, in Himalayan region, Himalayan region from Kashmir to northeast, or we can say in Punjab, and up to an altitude of 3000 meters, it is widely distributed in India. And other than India, it's also grows cultivate in Nepal, China, North America, Mexico. So these all are about the geographical source, biological source of the Dioscorea. And if we see about the cultivations and collections of the drugs, so for the cultivations, the soil should be sandy, loamy and clay type, and it should be well drained, and the plant prefer acid neutral and basic alkaline soil. So some these type of soils are suitable. Some acidic neutral or basic natures may be there, like sandy, loamy, clay soils are there. So these soils are suitable for the cultivations of the drugs, and they normally they can grow in semi shade or no shade. So there is no requirement for the shade. It requires moist soil, so moisture content should be high in the soil, and it can be cultivated by various method, like with the help of seed, stem cuttings, or by tubercles or tubers. So different parts of the plant we can cultivate this drug. And normally harvesting is carried out in the late summer and early autumn, when about the size of the pea and coming away easily from the plant, and then they should be potted up immediately in individual pots in a greenhouse or cold frame and transplanted out in early summer when in active growth. And if you see the macroscopic characters of the drug, so color is slightly brown, odor is odorless, taste is bitter, size is various size depending on the age of rhizomes, and it is a climber with alternate leaves. Rhizomes are soft, which are horizontally arranged and are very close to the soils, and the drug is covered with the scattered roots also. And if you see the microscopic characters of the drug, so there is the absence of the epidermis, so no epidermis is present in Dioscorea. And the cork is made up of few layers, and next to cork there is the cortical parenchymatous tissues with thin wall. So there is no epidermis, so first is the cork zone will be there, then after cork zone there is the parenchymatous tissues, and the major part of the drug is occupied by the steel, and there is steel is also present, and collateral type of fibrovascular bundles are present. So collateral vascular bundles, when the xylem is inside and phloem is outside, and they are radially arranged and in the radius forms, and the xylem will be inside whereas the phloem is outside. So it is known as the collateral type of vascular bundles, and they may be of two type, open type and closed type. So we can say that In open type, there is the cambium will be present, whereas in closed type, cambium will be absent. And it is the fibrovascular bundle, so it means the vascular bundles are covered by the some fibers. That's why it is known as the fibrovascular bundles. And drug has indistinguishable endodermis and pericycles. So endodermis and pericycles will be there, which is which may be indistinguishable, and these are about the chemical constituent. Diosgenin is the major active constituent of the drug, which is 4 to 6%, and steroidal sapogenin, it is a chemically it is steroidal sapogenin, and its glycosides isoleginin, epi-isoleginin, and beta isomer yamogenin. Okay, so this diosgenin is a chemically steroidal sapogenin, and its glycosides isoleginin, epi-isoleginin, and beta isomer yamogenins are also present. It's also contained sapogenase, which is an enzymes, and it's also consist some phenolic compounds and starch, which may be up to 75%, and you can see the structures of diosgenin. And commonly it is used as a main source of diosgenin, and modern medicine, it is widely used in modern medicine in order to manufacturing the progesterone and other steroidal drugs, and they can also be used as a oral contraceptives, in the preparations of oral contraceptives, and in the treatment of various disorder of the genitory organs, as well as in the host in a host of other disease such as asthma and arthritis. So it was all about the licorice and Dioscorea, and to prepare this lecture I use the C.K. Kokate book, Khandelwal books, Trees and Evans. So if you want more about these drugs, you can refer other books also. And so thank you very much for watching the video.